And welcome back to More Proof. I'm James. Today, I'm going to show you how to install one of these sexy USB outlets. Installing USB outlets is actually pretty simple. You're going to need the USB outlets. I picked these up from Home Depot. I got a 3-pack for like 60 bucks. You can also get them off of Amazon for about $20 a piece, and they also sell larger packs. So if you want to put them in multiple rooms of the house, you can definitely do that. You're going to need a flathead screwdriver, probably a Phillips screwdriver, an electrical sensor to make sure the power is actually off when you flip the circuit breaker, because that's step one. Turn off the circuit breaker, then test to make sure that power is actually off. You may need some wire strippers, and you're gonna need an outlet cover plate. All right, so let's go ahead and see what's inside the box. We obviously have three USB outlets. Pretty straightforward and simple. On the back, you're gonna have the gold screw. This is for your positive lead, your hot wire. You're gonna have your silver screw. This is for your white wire or your neutral. And then this little screw on the back is for your earth ground. So this is pretty much straightforward. You strip your wire back, you put it behind this little tab, and then you tighten down this screw and it pinches everything together. When you are selecting a USB outlet, make sure it's from a reputable company. I'm using Leviton because they're available in all major stores and they have legit UL listings. So these are gonna be about as safe as you can get. There's some other major brands out there as well. Just do some research on it. Try not to get the knockoff brands that are really, really cheap online, because if they sort of fudge the numbers on them to make them seem like they're safer than what they were and they weren't tested, you could potentially cause a house fire. So keep that in mind. But let's go ahead over to the outlet and dig in there, see what's going on. I've already turned off the circuit breaker. Now I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my tester. No beeping, so we are clear. Another thing to note is if one of these outlets was controlled by a switch, you cannot use this. So if your outlet, say the bottom one, turns on and off by a switch, but this one has power all the time, you cannot install this in that place. Just be aware of that. So let's go ahead and take off the cover, which seems to be painted to the wall. That was easy. Then you're gonna have two more screws here. Let's use that Phillips. And it's also a good idea at this point, before sticking your fingers in there, just verify there's no power. So as you can see, you have a white wire, you have a black wire, and then you have your bare ground. We'll go ahead and remove those. All right, now that we have our wires out, since we're not going to be putting these under the screws, I'm actually going to be putting them behind these small tabs, which you can see. Those push up and down. So I'm actually going to be putting the wire down inside there and then tightening that screw up. So we have to straighten these or strip them back. And because they're a little bit weird, I'm going to cut these. So we have a strip gauge on the back. Want it to be about that far. Should be about 3/4 of an inch according to the instructions. And we'll just match that up with the other one. That should be good. So we have our gold screw, which is for our black wire or hot wire. We have our silver screw, which is for our white wire, which is our neutral. We'll go ahead, put that behind the tab right here. Tighten this down. Make sure we have a firm connection. That's not coming out of there. Now we're going to repeat the same for the white wire. Put it behind the tab. And we'll tighten that screw up. And of note, if this was ganged into another receptacle, so you had four wires, two coming in on one side, two going out on the other side, Both black wires will go behind this tab. Both white wires will go behind this tab. We're going to take our earth ground. Put this under that screw. Then we're going to pinch it together and tighten it down. And keep some back pressure on it so it doesn't come out from underneath the screw. And after you tighten these down one last time, and be pretty forceful with this, you want to make sure that these wires are in here securely. If you pull on these and they come out, they're not tight enough. And there we are. All we have to do is put it back in the wall and put the cover on. And just go ahead and arrange everything back into the wall. We're going to tighten these two screws down and then we're ready to put on our wall cover. Just line that up. Tighten those down. You don't want to over tighten them, otherwise it will break. But we're all set. Let's go turn on the power and test it out. In the moment of truth. All right, it is charging. And thanks for watching More Approved. I hope you found this helpful. The installation of these is actually pretty easy. If you have any questions, make sure you consult a certified electrician. If you did enjoy this, make sure you like and subscribe. And if you'd like to see some more DIY videos, I've got a playlist down below. Thanks again. Till next time. See you then.